Motherfucker, I'm awesome. No, you're not, dude. Don't lie. I'm awesome. I'm driving around in my mom's ride. I'm awesome. A quarter of my life gone by, and I met all my friends online. Motherfucker, I'm awesome.
Hello, good people.
Hi.
Hello, good people. That Fallout 3 guy here to bring you the magical mystery tour of Let's Play Pokémon FireRed. Joining me today, I have a super special guest. Ladies and gentlemen, I bring you the Kingman Ultra.
I'm going to shank you.
And that is
with the rusty spoon that I have turned into a shank gnawing it into something sharp.
Why not just use a knife and cut out the middle, man?
Because that takes away the satisfaction and feeling of accomplishment when I do it.
But you're shanking someone, not winning a Nobel Peace Prize.
I'm winning the Nobel Shanking Prize.
Didn't know that existed. Right.
Inventing it after I kill all Nobel leaders or whatever.
Right. In the last episode, as you know, we basically dominated Erica's gym. Rygan showed me that he will be a valuable member of the party, even at this low level. This episode, I'm going to show off a couple things before I progress the plot. Yeah, this game has a plot, believe it or not.
We'll catch me, right? Right?
No. We'll see. We'll see.
Go fishing, goddammit! Surprise, I'm a water type.
I always thought I was going to win it back. Oh, wait. The hell? Oh, yeah. You get the, game, the coin case from that guy, and that lets you
that lets you go and play poker at the local strip bar, and then you get everyone arrested for being pedophiles because you make sure to lose and become naked because you're a sadist like that. You enjoy seeing other people imprisoned.
Wow.
You're a demon child.
Right.
You can come you're to Aaron as a child.
You can come to the game corner and, you can buy some coins here to use at the slots, or, you know, do what I do and use them to buy the TMs. You can exchange your coins for prizes next door.
Pokemon promotes gambling.
Yeah, which, it's stupid because in, like, the fourth generation onwards, they had a really fucking bad Sudoku-like game that was just, it wasn't fun. We exchange your coins for prizes.
Maybe you just aren't cultural enough to appreciate it.
These guys will give you some hold items that'll increase the stats of stats, and I think a yellow food. I can't remember what that does. Google it, because what do I look like, a walkthrough?
I just saw up a new evolution chain. Since they're a garbage bag and ice cream Pokemon, let's see a pawn evolve into a knight, which evolves into a king.
That's not a bad idea, actually.
They're inanimate chess pieces. They're objects.
Right, here you can get an Abra if you're too big of a lazy bitch to catch one. Same with the Clefairy. Now, Dratini.
Wait, I have to comment here. That just reminded me. I can't believe you caught a Pokemon without damaging it. The Growlithe, right?
Yeah, well, to be fair, it was asleep.
Well, I've never had that work for me. I always have to damage it. I've had Pokemon in critical red and asleep.
You saw what happened when I damaged it. It was not pleased. Right. I have to nitpick for a second here. Why is it that Dratini, something that evolves into one of the greatest Pokemon of this generation and of all time, actually, so much cheaper than something that, than two things that just aren't as good? I mean, Scyther's pretty good, but you can only get his evolution, which is beastly, by trading, and I don't think you can get it in the main story of this game. And Porygon, just, we had this problem with Luke, now we're having it with Noven. Porygon's just a gimmick Pokemon. That's nothing more, nothing less. And over here, you can get, in my opinion, the most valuable ones, a bunch of TMs. We'll be back here soon to get all these TMs because, my God, are they, we need them. Just.
Did you even realize that I dropped the call?
Yeah, I did. I commented on it.
Oh.
And we're going to be
rambling on like it didn't matter. Don't you love me?
I do love you, but I'm not in love with you. Right, here we have the Celadon Department Store, where you can buy all sorts of nice little goodies. Can't remember which floor it is that we need to go to. Is it this one?
You told me I was getting sex for this. Now I'm not even interested in commentating with you anymore.
Yes, we need this. We need this a lot. Brick break. Just, yes. Do want.
You know how, like, their Rock Smash is the one that breaks rocks?
The useless one?
Yeah. Damn it. I always wanted to see Brick Break just be able to bust through someone's wall. Through doors, I just want to get through that wall. Let me into your house.
So what you're saying is you want to be the Kool-Aid Man.
Yes. There should be a Kool-Aid Man Pokemon.
Does he evolve from a packet?
Yes.
Weapon minus counter. Nah, I don't really want to learn counter.
And the packet is actually the second evolution. The primary evolution is some poor third world country worker in a factory.
That should not be funny. Here, what do we get here? Oh wow, Pokedoll.
What the fuck?
I have a phone call. I'll be right back. Right, that was pointless. This is what we mainly came for, a Firestone. We'll need that to evolve Raigan into one of the beastliest Pokemon ever.
Hurry, evolve him right now so he doesn't learn anything else ever.
Actually, I do need to keep him not evolved until I think level
49.
Yeah, you're funny. Oh, let's hear.
That's when he stops learning moves naturally, though.
Until about level 25, he'll learn Flame Wheel, which is a really good fire-type move. At least this early in the game it is. Right here, you can get items that increase their stats. They're really expensive, but they're worth it if you don't feel like EV training. And if you know what that is, then yeah. If you don't, then it's EV training is... Basically, it's for competitive stuff only. Do not worry about it at all for single player. It's just not worth it.
This is Generation 3 rules, right?
Mm-hmm. Why?
Girls will learn Flame Wheel at level 31. I have the power of the wiki.
Wow. Alright, remember those guys that they said they were thirsty and they won't let us through those gates because of it? In the original games, you could buy them some fresh water, soda pop, or lemonade. But in this generation, you have to get a special item to give to them, which we'll go get right now, so I'll be right back. Right, if you come to Celadon Mansion, you'll find this lady here, and she'll say you shouldn't spend all your money on drakes, try this instead. And you'll get the tea. It's unknown whether it's of the damn fine variety or not, but I'll use my educated guess and say since it quenches thirst and allows you to bypass a guard just doing his job, I'll say it is indeed of the damn fine variety. Alright, need to go into the Pokemon Center right quick.
Can you make sure to catch a shiny version of me? Because the shiny version looks so much cooler.
Yes, Noven. I'll make sure to do the, like, fucking 3,869 whatever it is, one in that, whatever. No, I'm not going to even attempt that. Do you know how long that would take?
What if you actually happen to find a shiny of me?
Shut up.
What if?
I'll catch it.
Yay.
What if it's a female though?
That's fine.
Why do you wish?
I don't care.
Right, I bought Brick Break in order to teach it to Tog.
Being a female would be more fitting, in fact.
We're gonna replace Karate Chupara with that. Brick Break is one of the best fighting moves in this generation. It has high damage. It can break Light Screen and Barrier, which are two fairly annoying moves. So yeah, teaching it to Tog, since he gets same type attack bonus, will be just complete and utter domination. Now we talk to this guy. I'm guarding this poster. Go away, or else. You know, I love how he says or else, yet he doesn't give you the option to actually go away, so it's basically just assault. He's assaulting us. You still here, Noven?
Mm-hmm. Sorry, I was just caught up looking at types. Can I tell you what I want to learn?
Ooh, Hyper Fang's gonna hurt. And no, you cannot, Noven.
I want you to teach me Tackle, Withdraw, Leer, and let me find out what TMs would be useless. Attract. Actually,
wow.
Hail, that's more useless.
Wow. Also, he's already faster than us, yet he lowers our speed.
Hail and Rain Dance, actually.
I'm not teaching it Hail, Rain Dance, Tackle,
and Return,
withdraw.
And Double Team. Hail, Rain Dance, Return, and Double Team.
Return's actually not that bad of a move. It can be really good, actually.
But it wouldn't have a single offensive move.
Return's an offensive move.
Wait, it is?
Yeah.
I'm not seeing power here.
Yeah, that's because it does damage based on the friendship of the Pokemon, and it can have a max damage rating of 102, which is really good. And Raigan just completely... Well, he didn't really dominate because that Raticate was being a cheap dick and using Hyper Fang. The Team Rocket hideout might be discovered. I better tell the boss. And he has the ability to phase through walls. Clearly we are dealing with supernatural beings of a greater existence that we cannot begin to comprehend. Hey, a switch behind the poster. Let's push it.
How about Aurora Beam, Blizzard, Surf and Dive? That one's actually legitimate. That'd be a good set, right?
Even though it's offensive. Not really.
It would be.
No, it wouldn't.
Is it what?
Right, if you come down here, you'll find an escape room, which, you know, lets you just exit the dungeon immediately. We're going to ignore this guy because he doesn't have any friends.
Wait. You will be using me as a partial HM whore, won't you?
For Surf, yeah.
What about Dive?
No, fuck no. Dive sucks.
Don't you need that in this game for
something? Yeah, but I'm just going to, like, catch a fucking... something, I don't know. What? No, you don't need Dive in this game. That's only an Emerald, Ruby, and Sapphire.
Yeah, alright. Yeah, fuck Dive then. I thought you needed that.
And he's gonna send out Drowsy. This could actually prove to be problematic because Drowsy's special defense is actually really high. Lowering its attack does nothing because it's a special attacker. I say...
Psychic types are always strong, doesn't it seem?
Actually, yeah, I can't think of any psychic types, excluding pre-evolutions, that suck. Now, what, Tog's gonna come on this just to spite me and be like, oh yeah, well, Goo Goo Poo Poo is shit.
That makes me think of, like, some retarded cousin of Jigglypuff, where it's all deformed and inbred.
Jigglypuff's southern cousin.
Wait, let me go find, like, that really grotesque Pokemon image thing and find out what the Jigglypuff looks like in that.
Oh, God.
That'll be Goo Goo Poo Poo.
Part normal, part psychic, and all of its stats. It has nothing good except HP, and it... Even that is just, like, a 90 rating for HP. Everything else is 1, so it gets one-shotted by blowing on it.
No, it'll have max HP. That'll be its only strong suit. No matter how many times I stab it, it won't die.
Okay. Can we skip this guy? You bitch!
Are you gonna give me double team, by the way?
Nah, it wouldn't benefit you at all. And of course he's gonna start out with Zubat. Like, you figure if they want to take over the world, they'd learn to get, like, more... Well... good Pokemon, aside from Zubats. I mean, Zubat's good, but they never evolve it. Like, why don't they arm their grunts with, like, a bunch of Bulbasaurs and shit like that? That would be...
Why don't they arm them with functioning AI?
Ooh, and Raigan's trying to learn Takedown. Takedown is actually a really good normal-type move. It, it does recoil damage. So it's kind of a double-edged sword in that way, but it usually doesn't do enough to hurt you unless you're an idiot and use it when you only have 1 HP. Like, I've actually seen some people do that. Mainly the AI.
Isn't there an item that negates recoil damage?
Oh, no, there's not an item. There's an ability that does it. So there's one recoil damage move called Double Edge, which does an ungodly, but an